At 54, Adil never imagined he'd have to start all over again as a produce clerk. In Mosul, Iraq, he owned a restaurant, liquor store, and his own home. But when ISIL edged close to his town, they issued a decree: convert to Islam, pay monthly tariffs, and help kill non-compliance, or face death. He fled at 5 o'clock. By 7, ISIL fighters had taken over Mosul.
We saw what happened to neighbors. They paid the money, and a few days later, ISIL killed them anyway.
Adil is typical of the 4,000 Christians who began fleeing Iraq for Jordan last August at a rate of 250 per day. Jordan's newest urban refugees, they are affluent and educated and work menial jobs to get by.
When they finally make it to Jordan, this Catholic church is the destination point for most of the thousands who have come here. It's here that they don't have to worry about persecution from ISIL, and they know they'll get help.
They often settle in Christian neighborhoods close to churches. They have run from ISIL, but know the threat is still close by.
We are surrounded by ISIL, Jabhat al-Nusra, and other extremists. So Jordan also faces danger. But we rely on our faith and trust our king and military.
In the face of that threat, Iraqis, unlike Syrian refugees, hold little hope of returning home.
Iraq? There is no more Iraq. It's finished. There's nothing to go back to.
Stephanie Fried, CCTV, Full Heist, Jordan.